Namaste to world over audience. I welcome all of you to this session of poster competition presentations and prize announcements. I welcome to this platform the anchors, Vaidya Reena Arora ji from Delhi and Dr. Gaurav Phul also from Delhi, along to Chaudhary Brahma Prakash, Charak Ayurved Sansthan, and Dr. Reena Arora, a consultant of repute from Delhi. I hand over this platform to Vaidya Reena Arora ji and Gaurav Phul ji for further proceedings.
Thank you, Reena
ji, namaste.
Good afternoon, all. I am Dr. Reena Arora from Delhi. I am coordinator of poster competition, and I am thankful to the organizers of IASF and principal coordinator of Wellness Conclave, Dr. Pawan sir, and giving us this opportunity to speak on this beautiful scientific platform. This festival, Ayur Festival, is of utmost importance. I have seen this type of festival first time because this is giving due importance to health, which is of maximum importance in our life. I think everything is less than the importance of health. Now, whole world is aware of this thing after COVID pandemic, that how important is our health. All other things are secondary. Health is first, health should be first priority for everyone. And now I will like to say one thing here. We are going to announce the results of poster competition today. I will like to say one thing. All the participants are winners of this competition. Don't lose heart if you have not got any prize. You spread awareness about health through these posters. I am very happy for all of you that you have made very beautiful posters and you are conveying your thoughts about awareness of health in the form of a poster. You share these posters on social sites, in RWAs, wherever you live, wherever you stay, spread awareness among general public, among whole world, that Ayurveda is the way to wellness. And I congratulate all of you for participation. You may not be winner today, but you are winner in front, in the eyes of coordinators and in the eyes of IASF, because you have done an effort. A person who is not doing anything is not a winner. You are winner. And now I welcome Dr. Gaurav Phul, who is a MRM expert and pursuing PhD from Paru University, Gujarat. Yes, and he has authored 4 books. And he has got recently an award of a national repute. And then he's master trainer for MRM Chikitsa in various state workshops under Department of Ayush. He is recipient of Vaidya Chandra Prakash Award. I was missing that name. And he has authored 4 books and many publications. He is resource person in WAC, IASF, NBT Arogyam, and various TV shows and social media platforms. He has got certificate in basic life support, global integrated course in nephro-urology, cognitive behavioral therapy from Oxford University, and educational videos on YouTube. You can learn Marma therapy from YouTube channel of Dr. Gaurav. I have also learned he is very good trainer in Marma therapy. I welcome Dr. Gaurav Phul.
Yes. Thank you so much, Dr. Reena, for giving such a beautiful introduction to me. थोड़ा ज्यादा हो गया
नहीं नहीं डिजर्व मोर देन दिस
थैंक यू सो मच एंड हेलो ऑल आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस पोस्टर कंपटीशन इवेंट ऑफ प्रेस्टिजियस इंडिया इंटरनेशनल साइंस फेस्टिवल एंड आई कांग्रेचुलेट द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स एंड एट द सेम टाइम थैंक्स ऑल द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड सच अ लार्ज प्लेटफॉर्म टू आयुष फ्रेटर्निटी And I think this is the second year of including Ayush in this IASF and this wellness conclave. So I had the privilege to be a part of this in last year's event also. So with this, I'll start the proceedings of poster competition. So when the poster competition was announced or the wellness conclave was announced, it received a very warm welcome from warm response from all over Ayush fraternity. And we received 56 entries in the poster competition from all over the country, which included students, clinicians, and academicians also. All the posters were praiseworthy, informative, and well-crafted. They deserve applaud and congratulations. Congratulations, everyone, to participate in this event. Few of the participants did not follow the guidelines properly given in the brochure. So we were forced to give negative marks for that. Otherwise, all the posters were marked according to pre-decided criteria, and those receiving maximum scores were rewarded. So, to judge this competition, we invited two special guests as judges to judge the event, which included Dr. Santosh Gupta, who is a graduate from Ayurveda and Unani Tibya College, Karol Bagh, and then did her MD Kaya Chikitsa from Rajiv Gandhi Postgraduate Ayurvedic College, Paprola, Himachal Pradesh. She is a par excellence clinician with a vast experience of 18 years almost. She ran a nursing home cum hospital in Bijnor for many years and joined academics in 2010. And presently she is at the post of Professor Agatantra in Vivek College of Ayurvedic Sciences, Bijnor. And our second judge was Dr. Pooja Kohli, who is another known face in Ayurveda. And her brief introduction is, she is a postgraduate in Kaya Chikitsa. She has prodigious skills in treating with Panchkaram and Ras Aushadhis. She worked as assistant registrar cum senior technical associate at CCIM. And presently, she is general secretary in Asya and associate vice president at Nirog Street. And she's a known clinician in Delhi. So both of them judge this event and gave scoring according to the pre-decided criteria. The results of the competition will be announced at the end of this session. So everybody, please keep your fingers crossed and be with us throughout the session. All the very best to everyone. Now, I would hand over the mic again to Dr. Reena Arora. Before that, I would just like to introduce her in front of you all. She's a well-known Ayurvedic practitioner, frequent speaker at All India Radio, TD National, and she has given many talks at corporate offices, RWAs, DTU, and Max Hospital, and many other organizations in Delhi. She was awarded first prize from Ayush Ministry in online article writing competitions competition recently. And she is the recipient of Rashtriya Nari Shakti Award and many other prestigious awards. She is a brand ambassador of Baidyanath Pharmaceuticals and a master trainer for Prakriti Assessment Criteria. And her health awareness programs can be easily seen on YouTube, and she is quite famous. So everybody can take benefit of watching her. And with this, I would like to invite Dr. Reena, please.
Thank you, Dr. Gaurav, for such a nice introduction. I don't deserve so much you have introduced me. Thank you. Now I'm starting my presentation. Yes, this is my introduction slide, as Dr. Gaurav has introduced me. Ayurvedic concept of wellness. This is my topic. I am giving a brief introduction for this. Yes, is it audible?
Yes, you are visible and audible too.
Yes, now the concept of this wellness is Ayurvedic concept of wellness is the theme of this Ayur festival. Ayurvedic concept of wellness means the concept which are described in Ayurveda for maintaining our health and wellness. A person who is physically, mentally, socially, and spiritually healthy is considered to be a completely healthy person, पेशेंट्स कम टू मी एंड दे शो मी द रिपोर्ट्स, डॉक्टर साहब ये मैंने टेस्ट करवाए आप चेक कर लो, इतना स्ट्रेस्ड होते हैं वो, अभी उनको कुछ भी बात करो तो दे कैन क्राई एट दैट मोमेंट, पेट साफ नहीं हो रहा, सारी प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, बट दे आर हेल्दी बिकॉज लैब टेस्ट आर नॉर्मल. दिस इज नॉट द वे आयुर्वेदा डिटेक्ट्स अ पर्सन इज हेल्दी और नॉट. देर आर मेनी अदर नॉर्मल्स डिस्क्राइब्ड इन आयुर्वेदा ऑन विच वी डिसाइड वेदर ए पर्सन इज हेल्दी और नॉट. सो ऋतुचर्या सद्वृत, दैट इज कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट. आई विल लाइक टू से वन थिंग अबाउट सद्वृत हेयर, हाउ टू बिहेव इन सोसाइटी, दिस इज सद्वृत, दिस इज वन टाइप वन आस्पेक्ट ऑफ सद्वृत. So children should also be taught in these days that you should know what is sadvrit. Then rasayan, everyone wants longevity, good life, healthy life. This is the rasayan. Then panchakarma, all the people are putting videos on YouTube. This is detox, take jeera water, take this. This is not only a detoxification procedure only. Panchakarma is actual detoxification procedure which you should undergo if you afford and if you can do these things. Then what is healthy person as per Ayurveda? One is in perfect health when the three doshas, the vata, pitta and kapha, digestive fire, that is your digestion, your assimilation and your metabolism and all the body tissues and components, the dhatus, the I will explain these, and the entire physical body, all the excretory functions. I will like to say one thing here. Daily, 80% of population takes some churan or something that so that their stomach clears in the morning. This is not normal. The physiological functions of urination and defecation are in perfect order. What is the perfect order of this? You go to toilet, you defecate, and you come out in 2 minutes. This is perfect. And your stool should be formed. You should have not to exert any pressure. These are in perfect order with a pleasantly disposed and contented mind, senses and spirit. Now, what is contented mind? You are happy like this every time from inside, not for social smile. And your senses are okay. You are able to grasp everything. You can see, you can taste, you can smell. And spirit, this is the Atma. Then World Health Organization defined health as being a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being. And not merely the absence of diseases or infirmity. This is the same definition of health as described in our books. Now, Ayurvedic Dinacharya plays a major role in staying well. So I am explaining this. First, you get up in the morning, that is Brahma Muhurat. The proverb early to bed and early to rise has long been known to world. I am sharing these slides with references. That means there is a lot of study on these things on Dinacharya. I am not saying you get up in the morning and do this. There are references with this also. One who sleeps timely at night and gets up early in the morning is able to keep good health. The fact behind this truth is that the pineal gland is responsible for secreting melatonin hormone and setting our biological clock and control sleep. The degree of secretion of this hormone depends on the time of the day. That is, in night, secreted amount is more, and in day, its amount is less. So if you are not sleeping in time, that hormonal disturbance will occur, and problems like PCOD, thyroid, obesity, sugar, cholesterol may arise due to this wrong routine. So it regulates sleep in day and night. Sleeping early at night is helpful in proper digestion of food, helps in increasing basic strength of an individual, because if your digestion is not okay, you cannot be strengthful person, and you cannot wake up early in the morning. So sleeping late at night disrupts the balance of hormones, and food is not digested appropriately, basic strength reduces, and subject is unable to perform actively in the day. So thus, to be fit and healthy, one must follow the basic rule. This is not necessary for patients. If they are not able to sleep at night, they will not able to get up in the morning. Then Shauch Vidhi, I have explained about this. After waking up early in the morning, one should go for defecation. No force should be exerted during defecation as it may weaken local muscles, and normal healthy person who has balanced vata, pitta and kapha will not face any problem during defecation. Most of the population is also suffering from amajatisar or indigestion, in which the stool is not flushed properly. It is not formed. So this is also a sign. These are signs according to Ayurveda, which a healthy person should see. And these can be seen only under the guidance of an Ayurvedic doctor. Now, these are Dant Dhavan Vidhi. There is also a study on these, that these plants are useful for dental health. That is Pterocarpus marsupium, Vijayasar, Calotropis procera, Pongamia pinnata, Nerium oleander. You can make a powder of these drugs and you can rub your teeth with these for cleaning, or you can chew a stick of these powders. That is Terminalia and Arjuna as a Directa Indica. And after chewing, teeth can be cleaned with a mixture of Soseria costa, that is coot, gingiver of a snail, salt, Piper nigrum, Piper longum, Terminalia cebula, Terminalia bilarica, Phalanthus emblica, Elaterium, cardamomum, and cinnamomum, along with honey. You can rub your teeth with these powders. And a mixture comprising of sesame oil, xanthoxylum elatum, and rock salt can be used for polishing on teeth to reduce stains for teeth. People who are suffering from occupational hazards usually suffer from straining of teeth, or the people who are eating paan or gutkha, etc. So we can suggest these things to them. And these combinations are good for dental health. There is a study of Singh and Purohit in 2011. Then regular application of Soviranjan and weekly application of decoction of Berberis aristata, that is Daru Haldi, improves the vision and cleans the eyes of dirt and foreign particles, increases lubrication and prevents dryness. Sarangi et al. Study on 2016. This is Anjan of Ayurveda, which should be done daily. Then Nasya. Nasya has huge importance, and I suggest to my patients in practice. All the ladies wants to glow their face. They want good hairs. All the population wants good eyes, strengthening. Their eyesight should be good. There should be no spectacles. And their memory power should be good. Their brain should be good. All purposes are solved only by Nasya. That is Pratimarsh Nasya. Put 2 drops of oil, badam oil, or this cow's desi ghee in your both nostrils. And then you stay for 5 minutes. And then you can do all other your dinacharya process. This is very good in all these things. This is also advised in COVID advisory. Danu Tel Nasya can be used for nasal larynx. This is a study in 2017 by Chudasma et al. Then air conditioning is the root cause of dryness, which is responsible for wrinkles. Even in winters, people used to sit in AC environment. And even in summers, they also used AC whole day. So there is dryness of skin. That dryness can be avoided by using Nasya therapy. And Nasya lubricates nasal passage and helpful in preventing dryness and respiratory problems like asthma and chronic cold. I have seen these very good results in my practice also. And it's helpful in preventing hair fall. I have used this in practice also. So you can do this. And very good for eye diseases and migraine also. There is a study on this by Thankan et al. In 2014. Then Gandush. Gandush means keeping oil or grit in mouth. It checks shedding of lips, waterlessness in mouth, that is dryness of mouth, dental complications, and impairment of speech, that is Swarabhang. There is a study on this of Singh and Purohit in 2011. Then there are 13 types of natural urges, such as urination, excretion, hungriness, etc., described in Ayurveda, which should not be stopped to remain fit and healthy. And what should be stopped? There are also dharaniya vegas, which should be stopped. Greed, anger, such type of vegas should be stopped for a good society. Then yoga. Yoga improves quality of life. There are a lot of research papers on this, and it's an important part of daily regime. One should do some yogasanas in the morning, and this also helps in preventing breathing complications. Then massage. Apply oil daily on your body, even in this winter season. This is very good. And there is a study on this by Shetty et al. In 2017 that it improves vigor and strength, and also improves circulation of our body, tones up muscles, prevents osteoarthritis, and improves glow of our skin. Now, what is Ojas? A person is considered Ojasvi. Previously, elders used to say, ye bahut ajasvi hai. Ye ajasvi usi oj se aaya hai. Basically, this ojas is inherent strength of an individual. We can increase this ojas by following Ayurvedic dietary regime, सीजनल रिजीम, आचार रसायन एंड सद्वृत्त. बल वृद्धि कर भाग अकॉर्डिंग टू चरक आर ओनली थ्री थिंग्स आर मेंशन्ड, उत्तम आहार विहार एंड योर हैप्पीनेस ऑफ माइंड एंड एक्सरसाइज. ओनली दीज थिंग्स कैन इंक्रीज योर स्ट्रेंथ. पीपल आर पॉपिंग लॉट ऑफ इम्यूनो मॉड्यूलेटर्स एंड फॉर इंक्रीजिंग इम्यूनिटी मेनी ड्रग्स आर सोल्ड ऑन इंटरनेट एंड इवन allopathic doctors are giving that take this for immunity, take this for immunity. If you cannot afford this immunity products, you follow these Ayurvedic dietary and seasonal regime, your immunity will be automatically increased. A person can be happy and healthy by following these only. Then two types of ujas are described in Ayurveda. One is in heart and other is in whole body. We should try to preserve ujas for good life. We should try to increase this ojas so that we are least affected by any disease. I would like to say one thing here. Rome was not built in a day. Same is the case with ojas. This is also not built in a day. You have to do effort daily for this, for maintaining this oj and increasing this oj. Follow Ayurvedic Dincharya, Ayurvedic seasonal regime and all the things which are explained further in posters also for wellness. If we are physically and mentally strong, then these things will least affect us. Even the second wave of COVID is coming. Increase your ojas for preventing this. Our body is made from food we eat. And if we know which food should be taken and how, many diseases can be prevented. And diet of a person should be decided according to prakriti, season, appetite, profession, and liking. These diet charts are roaming on the social sites. All the dietitians and other people advising diets without seeing a person, which is very wrong according to Ayurveda. I am citing an example here. If a person is a Vata predominant constitution and you are advising that take neem water, this is very good for you, joint pain may start by increasing Vata of that person. This is just one example without showing a doctor if you are taking the diet of other person. In Swasth Chatushk, which is a group of four chapters for maintaining health, first chapter is on diet because of its utmost importance. Good food provides energy, good complexion, happiness, and longevity. And if we are not taking good food, we will not get energy, good complexion, happiness, and longevity. So we should take good food advised by an Ayurvedic doctor. I will also cite one example here. Previously, the king usually keep an Ayurvedic doctor in his kitchen. You know why? Because he wanted his food should be maximum healthy. So by knowing the diet from an Ayurvedic doctor, you are like a king. So be a king. These are some references of papers from these topics. And one paper I have studied, why we are suggesting seasonal regime. Solution to lifestyle disorders is only seasonal regime according to Ayurveda. There are some physiological changes in our body as the season changes. So our diet and lifestyle should be changed. Ayurveda is so scientific, you cannot think about the depth of Ayurveda. I am citing only one example here. See, there is a ginger water advised in Vasant Ritu. In Vasant Ritu, usually kapha predominates. Everyone is suffering from cough and cold. And ginger water cures that. This is advised in seasonal regime of Vasant Ritu. So see the scientific explanation given by Ayurvedists of our time.